Hello everyone, and welcome to tonight's stream. Tonight I'm going to be playing the Stanley Parable, as you can see over here. I have never played this game before. I have only heard that it's good. I really have no clue what to expect with this, and I already right off the bat really like that I'm like on a computer, on a computer, on a computer. That's pretty cool. So we're going to give this one a shot. And if you have any questions, feel free to let me know. I will answer them as best I can. Like I said, I have never experienced this one before, so we will see how it goes. I've heard this game can take anywhere from, like, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes to maybe 30 or 45. There's an achievement for finishing it, like, around 4 minutes. I think so. Clearly, it's possible. I'd be really interested to see how it turns out. And I also heard you probably want to play through it a couple of times.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on the keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor at his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-ripping, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy.
Good for Stanley.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
All right. Clicking doesn't seem to do anything. Space bar, nothing. Okay, well. Okay, so clicking does something. But just
all of his
right
co-workers
now
were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Hopefully you saved your work, sir, your man. That's a lovely picture. Very bright outside. Gotta conserve energy. That's what I'm doing here. Well, hopefully none of this is important.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
All right, I like that.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Ooh, or did I?
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Yes. Rebel without a cause here.
Yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
I will not follow instructions. See where that gets me.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
I'm gonna get myself in trouble. Ooh, key card there. Do not jump from the cargo lift. Will cause death.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about. Please. Stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her. This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself. To put your work aside. To let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Gladys? I feel like he's talking about Gladys. Attack of the eyelash. All right. No. Okay. Ooh, this looks ominous.
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this, to reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone. As Stanley picked up the phone, a white light engulfed him, filling him not just with radiance, but with hope. Hope for a life reunited one... Wait. Oh, goodness. Stanley, did you just unplug the phone? No, that wasn't supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly. I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check. No, it's definitely here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone, he's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits. Not picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed to mean anything. I don't understand. How on earth are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner? You're not Stanley. You're a real person. I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices, and to think I've been letting you run around in this game for so long. If you've made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making, or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world. Please observe this helpful instructional video.
Choice. It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, it can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Stephen has a choice. He could spend years helping improve the quality of life for citizens of impoverished third world nations. Or he could systematically set fire to every orphan living in a 30-kilometer radius of his house. Which choice would you make? Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought, then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack."
Okay.
Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a healthy decision-making process. Most medical professionals recommend making at least 8 choices per day. Do you make more than 8? Less? And finally, if you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant, and the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Ah, welcome back.
Ooh.
You may have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry.
Hey, Candyman,
now that you're properly
follow.
Informed
appreciate
on good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made just a few minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
Okay, let's see. How can I mess this up even more? Exit. No? Okay. Alright, so I can't go back. Looks like it's forcing me to go back.
Now that your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying. Imagine the main character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That story would make no sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
Okay. I think next time, can I move? Oh, so this fence wasn't here last time. If I play through this again, I think I'm gonna try and like jump off here onto that balcony. I feel like I could have done that before. I did not give it a shot though. Okay. Open the door for me. What in the world am I playing? It's called the Stanley Parable. I've heard is that it's fun and good. That's it. So I thought I'd give it a shot, and I like it so far.
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending. The story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
I don't know if I can trust this guy.
is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Oh man, I'm so tempted to go to the right. Can I go back this way? No. Okay.
No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Oh, whoa, things are getting all trippy. Okay. Let's do it again. Nothing different? Okay. All right. Ruin my fun. Okay.
Oh, it's ruined. I can't believe after everything we talked about that you... My story! You've destroyed my work! Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone? Left here like so much garbage, it's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do? Even if there were a way to continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? I can't erase that knowledge. I'll have to live with it forever. Reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do? What do I... No, I have to. I have to shut the game down. I have to. I have to. Thought you were so clever. Now look where we are. My entire game is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you run it into the ground. What, did you think that would be funny? You just had to see? Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it. That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it? That there's a world outside of you? You're a child. Oh, my story. If you'd just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect. I worked so hard on it. I tried so hard. ...is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay. I'm gonna try going right one more time to see if, it reset all the way and I can, like, jump off, onto that catwalk that I think was there. Think it was.
No! Why did you do that?
Oh,
quickly,
no.
Hurry! Is behave exactly as Stanley would.
Okay.
That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay. Hold on just a second. Okay. There we go. Sorry about that. Sound is really echoey. Oh, it's probably because, I've got the music playing out of my speakers. And I've got my microphone. Okay. too spooky for you, Candyman?
I know. No! Why did you do that? Quickly, hurry.
The narrator's voice is kind of echoey to begin
exactly
with.
As Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite
right,
sure
it looks like I have to go
to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
All right. All right. Here I go.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there.
Do not alter that consulting whiteboard. Ooh, there's a whiteboard manager? Oh, what an awesome job. Financial panic meeting? We're broke Wednesday? Nice. Bosses inspection, mergers. Pranking floor 5 meeting? Oh, that one would be awesome. What to do about 432? Don't tell 432 about the meeting. Office party. Nice. Cabal planning? Group planning? Uh-oh. Rest in peace, Franz. Yikes. Get Chris out of the broom closet. Employees. Huh. Man, this is all so interesting. Oh, a TPS report? Everyone likes. Oh, that says Initech. I'm pretty sure Initech is the name of the company in the office where TPS reports are made such a big deal of. Oh, that's fantastic. What else do we have? More water coolers, more water cooler heaters. Church need to be more hip to appeal to teenage demographic. Find teenage put nice. Some sort of child trap. I don't know if you can see. Yeah. Teenagers, size demographic. Okay. There's nothing in the ideas bin. What do people want? Things, money. More money, happy feelings, Mike James, you're fired. Nice. Solving interpersonal conflict. What are your dreams for the future? Talk radio. Yep, they know me. Talk radio. Oh, you can read the board. Okay, good. Cool. Man, you could probably... Oh, you could spend a lot of time reading all this stuff. And, I mean, if you work in corporate America, which I'm sure there's probably a good likelihood that many people do, all this stuff is just like... It's funny. Ooh, the broom closet. I feel like one of the employees was supposed to be in the broom closet.
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Well, I can't jump, so I think I don't have a choice there. Can I turn this? No? Okay. Ooh, schmancy office.
Stepping inside his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, until he saw the door with a voice receiver next to it. Surely behind this door lay all the answers to his questions. And beyond all probability, he knew the passcode. He had seen it on his boss's computer just last week. Nightshark 115. Was this the code to open the door? Would it still work? There was only one way to find out. Stanley had been trained never to speak up, but now he would draw from within himself the courage to face the unknown. He drew a sharp breath and then spoke the code.
Nightshark 115.
Stanley spoke the code. Nightshark 115. He spoke it into the receiver, right there on the wall. I'm sorry, is there a problem? You didn't mishear me, did you? Please speak the code into the receiver. Otherwise, we can't get on with the story. This is a crucial step. Okay, fine, you're not gonna do it. But you know what? It's pretty humiliating to bring you this far, only for you to suddenly decide you have better things to do. I asked you for this one single thing, for your respect. The kind of respect Stanley shows for his choices. He knows what it means to take a story seriously. If you didn't want to see what I had to show you, then why did you come here? You had a choice, you know. You could have gone through the door on the right. You could have done whatever the hell you wanted over there. Why did you come this way? Speak. Say something to me. Explain yourself, you coward. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What? Okay.
Stanley? Hello? Are you... Is everything okay? Stanley, please. I need you to make a choice. I need you to walk through the door. Are you listening to me?
What?
Can you hear me?
Okay.
Is everything all right? Stanley, this is important. The story needs you. It needs you to make a decision. It cannot exist without you. Do you understand me? Whatever choice you make is just fine. They're both correct. You cannot be wrong here. We can work together. I'll accept whatever you do. I simply need you to take that step forward, please. Choose. Do something. Anything. This is more important than you can ever know. I need this. The story needs it. So, you hear me? Are you there? Are you listening to this? Stanley, are you there? Okay. It's okay, I can wait. You need time to decide. Time to make sure your choice is correct. That is the best choice. That's all right. I'll wait for you to decide what's the right thing to do. Take as much time as you need.
Broke the narrator? Yeah, no kidding. Okay, so that was ending number one, I guess. Alright.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps.
Now I'm going to try and jump off that.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, this was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it. Wow. Yes. This room. But eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
Nope.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Okay.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm
got
not
the
sure
recent Humble Bundle? Really no, I had this from before. I can't remember where exactly.
Difficult, but the fact is okay, that I'm the story has been about nothing but you.
Geronimo!
All this time.
Oh, I made
really?
It.
I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others? Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you? Why, I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful. Look, let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance.
An achievement for clicking on door 435 times? Alright, if I get back to it, I will do that, I think. I've come to a different part of the office here.
Now listen carefully, this is important. Stanley walked through the red door.
Ooh, I feel like walking through the blue door. Yeah. Blue's better.
Perhaps you misunderstood. Stanley walked through the red door.
No. It's gonna be blue.
I still don't think we're communicating properly. Stanley walked through the red door.
Ooh, yes! Blue door!
Alright, fine. Go ahead, Stanley. You want to know so badly what's out there? You want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you. You see? There's nothing here. I haven't even finished building this section of the map, because you were never supposed to be here in the first place. Broken rooms, exposed developer textures. Is this what you had wanted?
Yes.
Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you? Do you not think I put a lot of time into that? Because I did. And in the end, it was all for nothing. Because this is what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours. What would have made this game better? What did you want to see? Vehicles? Skill trees? Work with me. You've given me absolutely nothing so far. Tell you what. Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design, and you can give me some feedback. There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
Okay. Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free to be honest. I'm looking for some real critical feedback here.
Yes.
Aha! You see, I knew I was onto something. Where do these flashes of inspiration come from? How did I know the game needed a third door? Well, it's instinct mostly, a calling in your gut. I really couldn't say where the idea came from, except that I felt it in my soul. You can't teach that, Stanley. Don't even try. Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough, I've compiled a new version. And to be perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one. Let's take a look.
Ooh, yeah. Good old Neil. I'm objectively ranked last, okay. Why not ask some friends for help? Apparently need help. Oh, friends is empty. That's cruel, man. That is cruel. Dead rat. Okay. I'm gonna go through this door again.
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors? Again, honest answers, please. Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been working on, and now would be a lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting. You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect. Let me boot it up. In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger. You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail. It's a very meaningful game.
Oh, no.
All about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life. I think the art world will really take notice. But of course, the message of the game only becomes clear once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
That's cruel, man. Okay. I wonder if you can actually do this for 4 hours and you get an achievement for it. Oh, that's awful. This is awful. Alright.
You heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because if it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me.
I'm a monster, I know.
I'm out, I'm done. It's over. Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable. Oh, hey, since my game was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game, just to ease the pain? Let's see.
What do we have here? Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
Well, oh, Minecraft. Is this any better? Nice.
At last, the one thing you've always desired. A game I had absolutely nothing to do with. But is it enough? Tell me that, Stanley. Will it ever be enough? Well, I'll say this. I'm done making things for you. From now on, I will only create to fulfill a greater artistic purpose. Watch this, Stanley. I'm going to build a house. This will go here. No, here. And then... Let's see, what does it need? Yes, of course. And just to finish it all off... Yes, it's complete. I made this, Stanley. Look at it. Gaze upon my work of art and feel ashamed at your own inadequacy. Ah, but you've only seen it from the outside. You've only gotten half the experience. Please, step inside and make yourself comfortable.
Oh, I wonder if I can refuse and he's going to be mad because I don't go through the door. I mean, I can't go anywhere else. Oh, what the heck.
Isn't it grand? Isn't it perfect? It could only be better if... Wait, that's it. We must rebuild it out of diamond. Diamond everything. Yes, yes, yes. Come along, Stanley. We have to go mining.
Oh, nice.
Oh, my. It looks like it's going to get a bit dark. Have you brought a light? Oh, no, 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 no. This is far more open-ended than I had in mind. I'm looking for something more narrow and linear. Something that makes you feel utterly irrelevant. This won't do at all. 1 out of 5. Even the diamonds couldn't save this one. Okay, new game.
This is awesome. Oh, so there are YouTube videos of people doing it for 4 hours with the baby thing. Oh man, that's insane. Portal!
Yes! I don't even know what this game is, but I love it. You, trapped in a glass box with no way out, listening to me talk. Oh, it's inspired. I couldn't have done it any better myself. What is this game even supposed to be? I can't figure it out. Okay, now I'm curious. Let's go find out what the hell this is.
Oh man, how did... Now I'm really curious to know, like, how they got the okays to work on all this stuff. I mean, they've already seen, like, a lot of different Easter eggs.
Ooh, it's a puzzle.
Critical thinking, Stanley. You're forte.
Oh, man, and I love Portal. This is great.
Genius. No, actually, you know what? I think that's plenty. Oh. I really don't care much to see you stumble through any more of these games. And I highly doubt you're any wiser for the experience. Which is why, rather than continue to waste my time, I'm just going to leave you here. You can pretend you've beaten the game if it makes it any richer for you, but as for me, I've had enough. So, why don't you get cozy in this room, and if you have any grand revolutionary ideas for the perfect video game, you can just sit there and let it ball up inside you for all eternity. I don't need your advice. I don't need your ratings. And I certainly don't need the validation of a man whose job is to push buttons.
Well, I think I'll George Jetson would be a business,
making meaningful cultural contributions to the world. And perhaps every now and then, I'll think back to a man named Stanley who was objectively wrong in every decision he ever made. The thought won't last long. Goodbye, Stanley. Good luck with your work. And I sincerely...
Ooh. Stanley Parable started out as a Half-Life mod. Already probably seeing it? No. Oof. Huh. Well, this is kind of a little creepy. Yeah, this is really fascinating. I'm glad I somehow managed to make it this far without not actually knowing... Ooh, a light. Like, what's going on in this game. Ooh. Okay. No, not getting in. Hey, my office. Whoa, upgrade. Huh. Okay. Oh.
I wonder what he found. If what he wanted was to be the leading man in his own story, well, perhaps he's gotten it. Down in wherever he is right now. I wonder if he's happy with his choice, and if he's learned the heavy cost that comes with it. He'll understand soon what I was trying to tell him. He needs me. Someone who will wrap everything up at the end, to make sense out of the chaos and the fear and the confusion. That's who I am. That is what I mean to this world. Oh, yes. Yes, I'll be back. There's no other way. Once this ends, after it all comes to a close, then I'll be back. The end will be here soon. Very soon. I can wait.
Okay. All right, so we think door 430 is the one that gets me achievement. Let's see.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Oh, please. Are you really just doing this for the achievement? Click a door 5 times. Is that all that you think an achievement is worth? No. I can't just give these merits away for such little effort. A measly 5 clicks. Now suppose you were to click the door 20 times. I would say that's the kind of effort that warrants recognition. I have to say I'm still not feeling the satisfaction of witnessing true effort for a noble cause. Perhaps 50 clicks will do it. Yes, almost certainly 50 clicks.
Okay.
No, I'm still not feeling it. I want this achievement to have meant something. It has to be a true reward for valiant effort. I want to see some hustle, Stanley. I want to see commitment, a willingness to go all the way, no matter what the cost. Why don't you go put 20 clicks into door number 417?
Okay. 417. So 417. Ah, here we go.
Oh, great. Now, go click a few times on door 437.
Okay. Oh, no. Back this way.
When Stanley came to a set of 2 open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Okay, fine. Oh man, it's going down. Blast.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an answer there. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. But Stanley just couldn't do it. He considered the possibility of facing his boss, admitting he had left his post during work hours. He might be fired for that. And in such a competitive economy, why had he taken that risk? All because he believed everyone had vanished. His boss would think he was crazy. And then something occurred to Stanley. Maybe, he thought to himself, maybe I am crazy. All of my co-workers blinking mysteriously out of existence in a single moment for no reason at all? None of it made any logical sense. And as Stanley pondered this, he began to make other strange observations. For example, why couldn't he see his feet when he looked down? Why did doors close automatically behind him wherever he went? And for that matter, these rooms were starting to look pretty familiar. Were they simply repeating? No, Stanley said to himself, this is all too strange. This can't be real. And at last, he came to the conclusion that had been on the tip of his tongue. He just hadn't found the words for it. I'm dreaming! He yelled. This is all a dream! Oh, what a relief Stanley felt to have finally found an answer, an explanation. His co-workers weren't actually gone. He wasn't going to lose his job. He wasn't crazy after all. And he thought to himself, I suppose I'll wake up soon. I'll have to go back to my boring real-life job pushing buttons. I may as well enjoy this while I'm still lucid. So, he imagined himself flying and began to gently float above the ground.
Ooh.
Then he imagined himself soaring through space on a magical star field, and it too appeared. It was so much fun, and Stanley marveled that he had still not woken up.
How was he remaining so lucid? And then perhaps the strangest question of them all entered Stanley's head. One he was amazed he hadn't asked himself sooner. Why is there a voice in my head dictating everything that I'm doing and thinking? Now the voice was describing itself being considered by Stanley, who found it particularly strange. I'm dreaming about a voice describing me, thinking about how it's describing my thoughts, he thought. And while he thought it all very odd, and wondered if this voice spoke to all people in their dreams, the truth was that, of course, this was not a dream. How could it be? Was Stanley simply deceiving himself, believing that if he's asleep, he doesn't have to take responsibility for himself? Stanley is as awake right now as he's ever been in his life. Now, hearing the voice speak these words was quite a shock to Stanley. After all, he knew for certain, beyond a doubt, that this was in fact a dream. Did the voice not see him float and make the magical stars just a moment ago? How else would the voice explain all that? This voice was a part of himself too, surely, surely, if he could just... He would prove it. He would prove that he was in control, that this was a dream. So he closed his eyes gently, and he invited himself to wake up. He felt the cool weight of the blanket on his skin, the press of the mattress on his back, the fresh air of a world outside this one. Let me wake up, he thought to himself. I'm through with this dream. I wish it to be over. Let me go back to my job. Let me continue pushing the buttons. Please, it's all I want. I want my apartment, and my wife, and my job. All I want is my life exactly the way it's always been. My life is normal. I am normal. Everything will be fine. I am okay.
Stanley began screaming.
Please, someone, wake me up. My name is Stanley. I have a boss. I have an office. I am real. Please, just someone tell me I am real. I must be real. I must be. Can anyone hear my voice? Who am I? Who am I?
And everything went black. This is the story of a woman named Mariella. Mariella woke up on a day like any other. She arose, got dressed, gathered her belongings, and walked to her place of work. But on this particular day, her walk was interrupted by the body of a man who had stumbled through town talking and screaming to himself, and then collapsed dead on the sidewalk. And although she would soon turn to go call for an ambulance, for just a few brief moments, she considered the strange man. He was obviously crazy, this much she knew. Everyone knows what crazy people look like. And in that moment, she thought to herself how lucky she was to be normal. I am sane. I am in control of my mind. I know what is real and what isn't. It was comforting to think this, and in a certain way, seeing this man made her feel better. But then she remembered the meeting she had scheduled for that day, the very important people whose impressions of her would affect her career, and by extension, the rest of her life. She had no time for this, so it was only a moment that she stood there, staring down at the body. And then she turned and ran.
Man. Well, that was a sad ending. Okay, so let's try and make, like, every correct decision. Oh, wait a second.
Good morning. Thank you for contacting the Future Happiness Foundation. We are confirming your shipment of 1,327 cardboard boxes to your place of work. Can you verify that this is correct? Excellent. Your order will arrive shortly. Thank you again for contacting the Future Happiness Foundation.
You're welcome. Okay. Lots of cardboard boxes coming my way.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left. Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office, hoping he might find an coming to a staircase. Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Oh.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this, what dark secret was being held from him. What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known this. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Yes, fascinating.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job. Why did he feel this now, when for years it had never occurred to him? This question would not go unanswered for long. Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
Fine. Playing this one straight.
The lights rose on an enormous room packed with television screens. What horrible secret did this place hold? Stanley thought to himself. Did he have the strength to find out?
Okay, so I can't, like, fall down there. It's like the room with the architect from The Matrix.
Now the monitors jumped to life, their true nature revealed. Each bore the number of an employee in the building, Stanley's co-workers. The lives of so many individuals reduced to images on a screen, and Stanley, one of them, eternally monitored in this place where freedom meant nothing. This mind control facility, it was too horrible to believe. It couldn't be true. Had Stanley really been under someone's control all this time? Was this the only reason he was happy with his boring job? That his emotions had been manipulated to accept it blindly? No. He refused to believe it. He couldn't accept it. His own life in someone else's control? Never. It was unthinkable, wasn't it? Was it even possible? Had he truly spent his entire life utterly blind to the world? But here was the proof, the heart of the operation. Controls labeled with emotions, happy or sad or content. Walking, eating, working, all of it monitored and commanded from this very place. And as the cold reality of his past began to sink in,
Stanley decided that this machinery would never again exert its terrible power over another human life, for he would dismantle the controls once and for all.
Sure, I can do that. Okay. Oh, that's a big red button. No? Okay. Big screen.
And when at last he found the source of the room's power, he knew it was his duty, his obligation, to put an end to this horrible place and to everything it stood for.
Maybe?
Blackness, and a rising chill of uncertainty. Was it over? Yes. He had won. He had defeated the machine, unshackled himself from someone else's command. Freedom was mere moments away. And yet, even as the immense door slowly opened, Stanley reflected on how many puzzles still lay unsolved. Where had his co-workers gone? How had he been freed from the machine's grasp? What other mysteries did this strange building hold? But as sunlight streamed into the chamber, he realized none of this mattered to him. For it was not knowledge or even power that he had been seeking, but happiness. Perhaps his goal had not been to understand, but to let go. No longer would anyone tell him where to go, what to do, or how to feel. Whatever life he lives, it will be his. And that was all he needed to know. It was, perhaps, the only thing worth knowing. Stanley stepped through the open door.
Yeah, that does seem to be the only way to go. I feel like I'm gonna like fall through the floor.
Stanley felt the cool breeze upon his skin, the feeling of liberation, the immense possibility of the new path before him. This was exactly the way, right now, that things were meant to happen. And Stanley was happy.
Hooray! Okay, I'm gonna try...
Even now, Stanley's office was a distant memory. What did it look like? There was a computer, perhaps, and a painting. Was it a painting or a photo? He could no longer recall. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Alright, so I'm gonna try following the escape route.
Yet there was not a single person here either. Feeling a wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go up to his boss's office. Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office. Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life. What could it mean? Stanley wondered aloud to nobody.
He began wildly tearing through papers on the boss's desk, pulling books off the shelf, looking behind paintings, desperate for clues to his situation. But his attention was caught by a keypad behind the boss's desk. What could its purpose be? In fact, this keypad guarded the terrible secret that lay buried below his feet. And so the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number, 2845. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, Stanley happened to input the correct code by sheer luck. Amazing. He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Alright, so I think I'm gonna take this, like, escape route, like I said. And then... see. I didn't want
Stanley
this video to get
straight
too long,
through the large
but,
door the red mind control facility.
So fascinating.
Although this passageway had the word escape written on it, the truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Okay.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track. At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Okay. Bit of a mess step, perhaps? Oh, dear.
As the machine whirred into motion, and Stanley was inched closer and closer to his demise, he reflected that his life had been of no consequence whatsoever. Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story, trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this truly is. Perhaps his death was of no great loss, like plucking the eyeballs from a blind man. So he resigned and willingly accepted this violent end to his brief and shallow life. There now, Stanley.
Oh, man.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator, as Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated as the machine crushed every bone in his body, killing him instantly.
Okay.
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game back in his office, as alive as ever. What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish? When every path you can walk has been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now? Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Sections have been added and altered throughout development, though the core layout remains almost identical. Okay, so that was my room. Yeah, I remember going through here. Let's see. Pacing of this opening section was important to get right. This corridor has been moved and altered to make sure the player reaches the two doors in a good time. 1-2. The set of two open doors was the very first concrete piece. The design was through to create the rest of the game emerges as an extension. Interesting. Okay. Ooh, solitaire. This is pretty cool. Like showing you all the assets. The button sounds okay. fun. Oh, the credits. Very nice. Okay, what do we got over here? Maintenance room. Mm-hmm. September, we submitted a Stanley Parable to Greenlight. Val's process of approving games for Steam. Greenlight page had only a series of cryptic photos, which were still enough to win the community's approval. That's cool. Oh, what's over here? Alien base. Ending where Stanley wound up on a battlefield fighting aliens. Action game would become sentient and would wage war against the narrator. Realized shortly after starting to build it that it was far too jokey and on the nose for the tone of the game. Plus, some people interpreted it as making fun of people who like shooters, which was not our intention. Well, there's nothing wrong with making fun of people who like shooters. I like shooters from now and then, from time to time. Question brought forth by the intent. Am I Stanley? Are you spying on me? After the second trailer we sent out, we asked people to email the narrator questions. While we had initially planned to use these in further promotional materials, we never found the perfect use. Here are a selection of those. Oh, cool. Fine selection of desert boots. Nice. Okay. The apartment timer. Alright, so clearly I haven't gotten to that part yet. Cargo lift. Right. Oh man. This place is a maze. Part of the Zending. Third pool, a lever in the narrow describable color. Whatever they pull, okay. Clearly haven't gotten to that part yet. This is really cool though, all the different aspects of the game. We ran four major trailers. The first one released in 2012 features a series of broken rooms and the voice of the narrator. Foggy. Not just that little portion. One doorway to maintenance in the lounge. Two doorways to maintenance. The other entrance would be hidden depending upon how you entered. Okay. One doorway to maintenance. The flow of hallways following the first two doors was important to get right, since players will replay them so many times. Discuss the numbers. Ultimately, it was the simplest version that won out, which... The simplest version is number one? I think? Yes? Probably. Okay, let's continue on. desk. Oh. On my desk. My desk one, my desk two. Ooh, got an upgrade. My desk three. Okay. Oh, the exit, sure. Freedom ending. So I got the freedom ending earlier. Monitor room elevator. Countdown room. Haven't found the countdown room yet. Okay, haven't seen everything, but that's okay. We will.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free.
Okay. Beep.
Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another? No, perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail. Push escape and press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now, and it'll be your only true choice. If you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you.
Interesting. Yeah, let's do this. Okay. That's kind of a fun, interesting way to end. So that's where I'll end the stream for tonight. Thank you for tuning in and watching. This is a very fascinating game. I feel like that was just like spoiler central, but definitely better to play this game without knowing anything going into it. But thank you for tuning in. I really appreciate it. You can always feel free to follow me here on Twitch at Shade846. You can follow me on Twitter at Scott D. Anderson. And also be sure to go check out rectifygaming.com for all your gaming news and needs and wants and desires. But once again, thank you for tuning in and have a good night.